let's get to the news. President Biden today welcomed players from the 2020 WNBA champions Seattle Storm to the White House, but unfortunately, they didn't have any ideas about Afghanistan.
Well, thought I'd ask. Thanks for coming in.
The Pentagon announced yesterday that it has asked U.S. Airlines to help with Afghanistan evacuation efforts. Okay, but remember, they can barely evacuate people from LaGuardia. Republican Congressman Matt Gaetz married his girlfriend over the weekend. Apparently, it was the only way she'd let him have a bachelor party. Former President Trump was booed by his own supporters at a rally on Saturday after he encouraged them to receive the coronavirus vaccine. They came out to see you because they love you, and they ended up booing you. Man, you really are from Queens. It's a tense time in the studio. Former President Trump on Saturday criticized President Biden's handling of the situation in Afghanistan and said, quote, Vietnam looks like a masterclass in strategy compared to Joe Biden's catastrophe. But take that with a grain of salt because Trump never went to Vietnam or class. According to a new poll, President Biden's approval rating has fallen below 50% for the first time in his presidency. And if his approval numbers fall any lower, he could start to hit Trump's all-time highs. Today was the last day of New York Governor Andrew Cuomo's administration. Well, I'd say keep in touch, but that's kind of what got you in trouble in the first place. New York City on Saturday held its We Love New York City homecoming concert in Central Park. And to guarantee that the concert didn't become a super spreader, they held it in a hurricane. And finally, billionaire Elon Musk announced last week that his company is releasing a so-called Tesla bot designed to do unsafe, repetitive, or boring tasks. Basically, it was designed to hang out with Elon Musk. President Biden yesterday encouraged Americans who have been waiting for the FDA to approve the Pfizer coronavirus vaccine to go out and get the shot. But I don't know, something tells me they're gonna find a way to move the goalposts again. Sure, it's FDA approved, but is it farm to table? Something that's suddenly very important to me? Following the full approval of Pfizer's coronavirus vaccine, the company revealed it would start marketing the drug under the name Comirnaty. So now people will start referring to the Pfizer vaccine as the Pfizer vaccine. It's too late for a rebrand. This is like when your friend comes back from vacation and is like, actually, everyone calls me Turbo now. No, they don't. You're Andrew and you're still kind of lame. President Biden today met virtually with the leaders of the G7 countries to discuss Afghanistan and even pulled out of that a little too quickly. All right, look, if we're just going to point fingers, I'm going to sign out. The president of the Arizona Senate announced yesterday that the results of the state's Republican-led audit of the 2020 election will be delayed after several executives from the third-party company Cyber Ninjas contracted the coronavirus. Man, at this rate, we'll never get to find out what didn't actually happen. During his farewell address yesterday, former New York Governor Andrew Cuomo discussed the sexual harassment allegations against him and said he was treated unfairly. Yeah, what kind of white man whose dad was also governor only gets 10 years in office? On his last day in office, former New York Governor Andrew Cuomo issued one pardon, and this is weird, it was for future Andrew Cuomo. According to a new study, eating one hot dog takes 35 minutes off an individual's life. And in a tragic development, competitive eater Joey Chestnut has passed away in 1756 at the age of negative 227. A 5-year-old boy from Virginia recently became one of the youngest people to ever complete the Appalachian Trail, and his mom only turned her back on him for a second. And finally, it was announced yesterday that the Grand Central Oyster Bar, a subterranean restaurant in Grand Central Terminal, will reopen next month after being closed for a year. Finally, it's safe to eat raw shellfish at Subway level again. Shoemaker favorite, though. It is a shoemaker. I like it low. I like this. I like top shelf shellfish way down underground. President Biden today signed the Puppies Assisting Wounded Service Members for Veterans Therapy Act into law. Democrats are calling it a vital service, and Republicans are calling it tyranny. President Biden announced yesterday that the U.S. will keep its August 31st deadline to withdraw from Afghanistan, added Biden, because that's been the plan since the very beginning of the week. two members of Congress made an unauthorized trip to Afghanistan yesterday and stayed for less than 24 hours before leaving on a flight that was intended to be used to evacuate people from the country. In their defense, that's just how Priceline booked their trip to Cincinnati. White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki yesterday praised former President Trump for urging his supporters at a rally over the weekend to get the coronavirus vaccine and said the Biden administration, quote, will take anyone who has a big platform. Except right now, the biggest problem is the biggest platform. President Biden reportedly received a classified intelligence report yesterday that was inconclusive about the origins of the coronavirus, contradicting your uncle's report that AOC slept with a bat. According to a new study, antibodies from llamas may prevent infections from coronavirus. And of course, now you can't find any llamas at Costco. The New York Post this week published a negative review of the restaurant at the new Margaritaville Resort in Times Square. You think Jimmy Buffett cares? He's not even gonna see it. He reads the leisure section and the rest of the paper is just to shield his eyes from the sun. He doesn't even know that resort opened yet. It's 2021 already? Wow, that was a good nap. A theme park in Japan recently shut down a roller coaster capable of reaching speeds up to 112 miles per hour after four riders reported injuries. Apparently, what happened was the roller coaster reaches speeds up to 112 miles per hour. Online platform OnlyFans announced today that it will cancel plans to ban sexually explicit content from its site following an outcry from users. But after the outcry, users pretty quickly relaxed, and then they just fell asleep. And finally, Harvard Law School this week unveiled a new redesigned logo. It's a mom telling her friends her son goes there. President Biden met yesterday with executives from Apple, Google, and J.P. Morgan Chase to discuss cybersecurity, where they suggested not writing the nuclear codes on his hand. Senator Bernie Sanders is set to visit Iowa and Indiana this weekend to promote Democrats' new $3.5 trillion spending proposal, though it might have been better if he'd waited until after the harvest. Somebody help me find my way out of here! The CEO of Delta Airlines said in a new interview that he won't refer to the new coronavirus variant as Delta, though I don't think it's cool that he keeps calling it the Air China virus. The Los Angeles County District Attorney's Office announced yesterday that porn star Ron Jeremy has been indicted on more than 30 counts of sexual assault. Man, it's always the guy you most suspect. A zoo in Belgium recently banned a woman because she's having a self-described affair with a chimpanzee, which is negatively affecting his relationship with other apes. And just a guess here, hers with other humans? A luxury clothing brand that made a cashmere sweater that read Cuomo Sexual has offered to restitch sweaters for customers, though I'm not sure they came up with the most elegant solution. The makers of Mountain Dew have announced they will release a limited edition Flamin' Hot Cheeto flavored soda, and the FDA is already scrambling to approve a vaccine for it. That's right, the makers of Mountain Dew will release a limited edition Flamin' Hot Cheeto flavored soda, and fans are giving it two thumbs up. It works, it tracks, Shoemaker. A small plane recently made an emergency landing on a California highway. Drivers were shocked when a plane landed in front of them and Harrison Ford didn't get out. And finally, according to a new report, 2020 was Europe's hottest year on record. It was so hot, one guy in France almost took off his scarf. And that was a monologue, everybody.